Hello! Today we are going to be modifying an original NES controller so it can connect to the Wii controller. Now, what you're going to need is a Wii nunchuk. I got a cheap one off eBay, about $3 to $4. It could be third party. You just need the wire and the connector. And, of course, you're going to need a classic NES controller. And you're going to need a chip from rafnet.com. I'll put the link up in the description, and it should pop up in the video. Now, we're going to start with taking apart the Wii nunchuk. So do that. Now that you've got the screws out, you can take it apart, and you can take out the actual connector. You can take out the stress relief. Just need to pop it out. It's a little tough, but you just got to pull up. Now that you have it, you can take out and cut off at the beginning of the strain relief. You could also cut the other side. Now that you have both of them together, you can take a look at it and you can see that it's marked each wire so you know what each one does. Now we'll go back to this and I have my own schematics that I've drawn out for you, but it's nice to have it available so you know, because it might not be the same for every nunchuck. So now you can unravel your NES controller's wire. And we're going to start by unscrewing the controller so we can get inside. So take off those 6 screws. Now that you've got the screws out, you can set them aside and open up your controller so you can witness the electronics on the inside. Look at that. Amazing. So you need to unravel this so you can get the board out. There you go. You can set everything aside for now. You can unravel the wire and make sure you cut it at the very tip where those wires start to come out. Now, cut the connector. We're going to need that for reference later. Now that you have everything, you could put it into the controller again. Now that you've got it back into the controller, put the chip in to see if it fits. This is where I put it. This is the best place that I think it could go. Now, you want to be able to close it and open it without it smashing the chip. Now we need to take apart the connector. The connector needs to be pushed in with a flathead screwdriver or something and pushed out so you can open it and see which wires are on the inside. If you open up these sides, you could actually see the wires on the inside that correspond to the holes. Now, this is what I'm going to use as a schematic. I'll be running through it, but the first one is going to be the data cable, which is the bottom right to the PC2 on the chip. And I'll show you here. It's right here on the bottom right. Now, we need to find out which one that is. Now, I know I colored it in for you already, but it is the yellow wire. So, let's take that out. So, here's the yellow wire. What you're going to do is you're going to go to the board and you're going to, let me put the chip back really quick. You're going to take the yellow wire. You're going to strip just a tad at the end. You can tin it if you want. You should probably do it to make it easier. Fit it in the correct spot on the chip. And then solder the wire to the chip. Now be careful because these are such close proximity that you might end up soldering many bridges. But it's all right because you can rework it. And then make sure the chip still fits in the proper spot. Now the next one will be soldering the latch, the orange wire, to the PC1 on the board. Now, it should be this one, and you already know it's orange, so let's take those out. I cut them off as I go, so I just know that I've already done that wire so I don't get confused, because there will be wires that are the same color as we get towards the end. But for now, just worry about the orange wire here. Same thing, same operation. Strip the wire, fit it, or tin and then fit, whichever way you want to do it. Then solder it in. Careful not to make any bridges. If you do, rework it. Make sure the chip still fits in the same spot you're going to leave it. This is important for later. Now we're going to wire the clock, the red wire, to the PC0. Same thing again. Find it. It's the third one up on the right. And what color is the wire? Red, of course. Pull out the wire. Cut it off, just so you know which one you're working on. Now, strip the wire. Tin the wire. And fit the wire into its spot. Now solder the wire onto the board. Make sure it's still in the same spot. If not, make room. You can rework it. Now we're good to move on to the wires of the Wii connector. Now, one of these isn't going to be used. You see that middle one that's empty with no metal on the inside? That one we're not going to use at all. But the other ones we will. So we're going to do the clock, which is the bottom right, to the PC5 connector on the board. Which one is it? That's the clock. So we're going to use the green one. But first, we want to measure out how long, because we want the wire to run throughout the controller as well, and we need it to sit there. We're going to make a small cut here. And we're going to pull off the insulation. Now, you can see the clock is in the middle. It's the green one. So what we're going to do is make sure you cut that off so you know which one you're working on. You're going to take the green one and same operation. You strip it, you tin it, and then you fit it. Make sure it fits, you know. You don't want, the more wire you have to work with, the better. Then you solder it on. Make sure it fits in the same spot still. If not, make adjustments. Now we're going to do the data cable for the Wii connector, and it's going to go into the PC4 connection spot. As you can see, it is the blue wire. Strip it. Tin it. Place it in the board. Solder it in the board. Just make sure you don't make any bridges again. I know it's tough, but it takes practice. And now make sure it still fits in the same spot. Now we're going to take two wires, ground from both the Wii and the Nintendo, which are two different colors, white and brown. So the ground for Nintendo should be at the top right, which is the brown cable. So take the brown cable and strip it. Now we've got the white cable for ground on the Wii controller. Strip it. And then tin them and stick them onto the board. Now the first tab under the P0 spot on the board is the ground. So make sure you put both those wires there. Now we're going to put three wires, D-Tech, the V+, and the V+ on the Nintendo to the positive, which is the last tab on the board. The third highest on the left on the NES connector is the positive voltage. So we're going to strip that wire. We're going to tin it. And you're going to take detect and the VC, the positive voltage of the Wii, and you're going to put those together. So you're soldering three wires in the same place. So strip them both. Once you've stripped them both, hold them down together and the solder should put it nicely and compact for you. Make sure you cut off any excess wire at the end. Now I use a glue gun to hold this down for me. I don't want the chip bouncing around in there. You don't have to apply too much, just a dab like that. The good thing is that the glue won't tear off anything if it does have to be repositioned. So now that you do have this together, you can put it back into the case. Now make sure you insert the wire and place it in the correct spots. Now you can run the wire through this, which are going to act as strain reliefs in case you pull on the controller too hard or something. That way you don't rip up any soldering connections and you just basically pull the whole controller. Now you can test it out by putting on the lid, seeing if it fits. Make sure the wire is in straight, and it should fit perfectly. If there's a little pushback, that might be you put the wires on top of each other too much, but that's all right. Now make sure to put back all six screws. All right, now that you have that together, you can take a look at your brand new NES to Wii controller mod. Now that we have that together, we can test it out. So connect the NES controller to the Wii controller. Now, let's see this in action, see if it works. Let's turn on our Wii. All right. Now let me just. There we go. Just give me a second. I gotta. The TV's behind me, so. And let's pick a game that I like, my favorite NES game, which is not Bubble Bobble. All right. Do I have to? No, I guess not. All right. So let's see if this thing works. Yes. Well, let's see if it works in the real time. Oh, looks like it's responding well. I gotta say, there's no lag as far as I can tell. Wow, this is really cool. Who knew? Now, there's one thing I have to mention is that it won't work on the Wii menu because this controller, of course, isn't programmed. So you have to actually be in the game itself for it to work. So I guess that's one drawback from the Pro controller. But hey, it's the original NES controller to the Wii controller. How cool is that? Well, there you go. It worked. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you get your classic NES controller to connect to your Wii controller. Enjoy.